alligator to our left. We have 1, 2, 3 alligators in the water. There's that American alligator right there. There he is. That's what alligators do. Cover themselves in mud. Hey, peacock bass. Pop that back up again.
All right, ready? Enjoy tour?
Yeah.
All right.
All right, we just got off the bus over there. Excellent.
All right, I guess you guys in the back need coffee. My name is Captain Gus, guys. I'm going to take you guys up to the Everglades. How's that sound?
Awesome. Great.
I need more coffee. Oi! Look at Colada, my friend.
Colada, you want coffee? Caramba!
Enjoy tour, Aceres!
Okay. Hopefully you don't get eaten by alligators.
Enjoy tour! Enjoy tour!
Oh boy, this may be a mistake I regret, going on an airboat and not coming out here alive. Wow, look at those. Wow.
Alright guys, I'm Benny.
Just me.
Just you?
Yep.
Alright man, you go in the back row, you'll be with me.
Alright.
Right up there. How many in your group?
Oh, you gotta be careful, you can get your feet caught. Oh, this is going to be pretty loud. I'm right next to the propeller. Oh boy.
Rule number one, don't stick your hands in the water. It's common sense, but I gotta say it. After that, you do what you want. You're an adult. Stick your hands in the water. Don't feel the puppy finger. I already said what happens. Did you guys do the gator show, or you came, or you just got here?
This guy here.
Alright, so that's, those are the tamed alligators. You're from the wild alligators. You're going to do the gator show after the tour. And you guys kind of get the idea what they do in that gator show, right? They're going to grab that alligator out of that pool. They're going to show it to you. Drop those expensive iPhones in the water. And we'll not be doing any of that. Apparently behind the bars. Besides that, rule number two, have fun. Take pictures, take video. Lots of wildlife here in the Everglades, not just alligators. I'm trying to show you as much as I can. We'll talk to you about how the ecosystem works out here. Sounds good?
Yeah. Excellent.
Yeah.
trail to my left, this is called the first speed trail. Unfortunately, due to this time of the year, we're behind the dry season. Looks like it's deep water, but it's only a couple of inches out there. So that means a boat will get stuck, and if you look in the water on our left side, you'll see white spots in the water. That's exposed limestone, which will shred up the bottom of the boat, which means we'll sink. So speed trails are closed around this time of the year. That's the bad news, no speed on this tour. Good news is that the wildlife congregate to the deeper bodies of water, like this canal to my right. American alligator to our left. Give me 1 second to turn on the boat, turn the boat around.
Thank you.
racer snake in the water, black Everglades racer. Non-venomous. Also the only elevation you'll find as well. maritime mammal species, white-tailed deer, wild boar, possums, raccoons, marsh rabbits, and our Florida panthers and Florida black bears. Now, you don't need much elevation for these tree islands to form, only about 2 to 3 feet. That's because the Everglades is under sea level. Not to confuse you folks, this is all fresh water. The brackish saltwater areas of the Everglades are to our south and southwest. Sticking out of the water, just submerged.
Thank you.
Sergeant Mayo again. The spotted dock. Spotted dock tells you one thing about the water level. Says where the water is shallow. Spotted dock can only grow 8 feet out of the water. But the center of these canals can be 15 to 30 feet deep. These canals were dug out by the Army Corps of Engineers in the 1940s to build up South Florida cities and towns and to control flooding throughout South Florida. Beautiful yellow flowers that you see on the spotted dock are edible. They are a main source of the diet for the purple gallinules and our turtles. Like I said earlier, we have 5 freshwater species. Here to our left, we have 1, 2, 3 alligators in the water. And here to our right, we have the entrance to what us airborne captains call Vulture Island. We usually can go in there, but right now, due to the low water levels, we get stuck right in the entrance. As well, largest wading bird in the Everglades. The blue heron has a wingspan of over 6 feet. Now, if you look to our left, you'll see the water is very shallow. A couple of inches out there. That's the natural Everglades. Again, these canals can be 15 to 30 feet deep. We actually have an alligator to our right and to our left. One's going to the entrance of Vulture Island. Thank you. dry season is the time for the wading birds to come and feed in the Everglades. The Everglades is the largest breeding ground for wading birds in North America. Wading birds from all over North America and South America come to the Everglades, migrate to the Everglades to feed this during this time of the year. The water levels start to drop, the fish get trapped, so do the crustaceans and invertebrates, which the wading birds feed on. Now the wet season is the time for the fish to repopulate after the dry season. Also for our alligators, alligator baby season starts in May. Mama alligator will lay her eggs and prepare her nest in June. Baby alligators start to hatch in August. August is the month that has the highest water levels, most rainfall here in the Everglades as well. And that's why baby alligators hatch in August. Water levels to hide from predators, because when they hatch out of those eggs, they're only 6 inches long. Even though mama alligator does a great job of protecting her babies, out of the 40 eggs she lays, maybe one or two will make it to adulthood. When baby alligators sense danger, they do this call to their mom. Ow! 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 And if mom is nearby, she will charge whatever is threatening her babies. Just popped up behind us here to our left. Submerged again. There he is. That's what alligators do. Cover themselves in mud. Hey, peacock bass. Pop that back up again.
Oh my goodness.
Natural Everglades again, views like this is how we got that nickname, the River of Grass, given to us by Marjorie Stoneman Douglas. The Seminole tribe calls the Everglades Pahaoki, which means grassy rivers. That's actually what we're traveling through right now. We're traveling through a slow moving grassy river, a slow moving river of grass. The water in the Everglades is not stagnant. This is not a swamp. All this water has a flow. It flows south-southwest into the upper Florida Keys. Florida Bay, the lower portion of the 10,000 islands into the Gulf of Mexico, feeding the marine estuaries, coastal lowlands, saltwater marshes, and mangrove ecosystems of the southern and southwestern Everglades. The name for this type of river is a slough. The name of this slough is the Shark River Slough. It's 100 miles long, 50 miles wide, running through the center of the state of Florida. It's considered the liquid heart, the largest ecosystem, connecting and pumping water to all nine different habitats and ecosystems throughout the entire Everglades. to my left and my right at the entrance of this canal. You saw the pond apple trees.
Thank you.
Everglades a special place. Well, it's one of a kind. There's only one place like it in the world. That is the largest wilderness area east of the Mississippi River in the United States. It is the largest wetlands in the Western Hemisphere of the world. It's considered a World Heritage Site, an international biosphere reserve, and a wetland of international importance. Now, the Everglades gets these titles due to its biodiversity. The Everglades is also critical habitat for many endangered species, such as our Florida panthers, less than 300 in the wild today, our Everglades snail kites, which feed only on the native apple snail, the Cape Sable seaside sparrow, which you can only find in the southern Everglades down in Florida Bay, and our American crocodiles, as we've seen with the 15 plus alligators on this tour. This is all alligator habitat, all freshwater. Where this freshwater flows south, meets the brackish saltwater of Florida Bay, the Florida Keys, the mangroves of the Everglades, that's where you'll find the endangered American crocodile. Extremely important to us locals, the Everglades is our source of fresh water. Deep below the surface here of the Everglades lies the Biscayne Aquifer. Which provides fresh water for South Floridians. The Biscayne Aquifer also gets recharged by all this fresh water in the Everglades. And the water from the Everglades protects the Biscayne Aquifer from saltwater intrusion coming in underground from the Atlantic Ocean. Approximately 9 million South Floridians depend on the Everglades for their fresh water, including all the way north of Port St. Lucie, Lake Okeechobee, all the way south of the Florida Keys, and all the way west to Naples, Fort Myers. All depend on the Everglades for their fresh water. All right, guys, we are coming to the end of the tour, so just want to give a quick safety message. Please remain seated until another captain and myself tie up the boat. Please watch your step as you step out and watch your heads. That hard metal roof is still above you. Take your time as you step out. Make sure to grab all your belongings, cell phones, cameras, bags. If you brought any drinks or snacks on board, please take those with you as well. This is the part of the tour I don't like, but I have to ask. Guys, us airboat captains do work for tips. So if you enjoyed your ride through the Everglades with me today, if you enjoyed the information on the tour, and if you enjoyed the wildlife I was able to find and spot for you guys today, well, similar to a bartender or server at a restaurant, if you had a great time, a tip of 15 to 20% is highly appreciated. Don't forget, you have the Gator Show right after this tour, that is run by the Gator Boys and the Alligator Rescue, located right here at Everglades Holiday Park. So I hope you enjoy the rest of your day here today with us. For those of you folks on vacation, I hope you enjoy the rest of your time here in beautiful, sunny South Florida. And for my locals on the ride, well, welcome home. This is your backyard. Again, guys, my name is Captain Gus, and it has been an honor to take you through the beautiful wilderness of the Everglades, the one and only river of grass. So as we turn that corner up ahead, we'll be docking shortly. Want to thank everyone for coming out again, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day.
So much.
Thank you so much, man. Appreciate
all right.
It. Hope you got a good video, man.
Yes, excellent. I think I got the leaf throwing at me.
The leaf?
Yeah, when the alligator popped up and submerged.
Oh, man, that's cool.
Yeah. Take care. That was the Florida Everglades airboat tour here at Florida Everglades Holiday Park. If you enjoyed it, smash the like button because I thought it was so awesome. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you next time. Bye.